Alright, so I have the camera all set up and I also have the GoPro set up. So I'm gonna give you guys my opinion on just the pressure based fist system for airlift. So let's start going. I can say right off the bat, it still feels smooth and firm. Definitely say that right off the bat. It still feels smooth and firm. Let's go. So I'm gonna go on some back roads so you guys can have a good idea. Smooth, still drives smooth under the pressure, and it still has the equalization axle thing on, so that's nice. Smooth still under pressure, which is real nice. Under the pressure, it also has a thing called preset maintain, so even at whatever pressure ride height that you have on the car, it will stay at that pressure ride height. So it will, if you come to a complete stop, the system will know that and it will automatically start adjusting to maintain that ride height. So that's another pretty neat feature from Airlift. Pretty smooth. Of course, going over these little bumps, you're gonna feel little tiny bumps, but it's still good enough pressure to soak up the little tiny bumps. It's not overbearing or like really bouncy, which is really good. So I'm about to turn on to the back roads right now. Try to see how it is. Smoothness, it's still smooth to drive in the back row. It's really smooth, so I would say the pressure really feels nice. So now we're coming up on a little turn here. I'm gonna downshift and then I'm gonna ease into the turn. Not much oversteer, I'm moving just a slight bit in the seat, but not much. Here's another turn, and I'm gonna gradually turn it. I'm moving a slight bit in the seat, but not much, and it's still smooth. Hug that bump like it's nothing. Speeding up, still drives completely flat, running through the gears. Really flat, and keeps me in the seat. just a little bit. That's about it. Going over the, oh man, so nice. Hits the bump like it's nothing. I was going 41 miles an hour toward that bump, and it took it like it was nothing. All I hear was doop, doop. Took the bump like nothing, going 40. The bag's still fine. They did a really good job with the bag system compared to back in the day. If it, anything, if it would hit the bump too hard, the bag would pop. It really soaks up the hits and you really don't feel anything. If you hit a bump going 40 miles an hour, it's fine. Of course, you're not going to be running into potholes over and over and over again, but it definitely, these bags definitely soak up, know how to soak up any kind of bumps or dips. And if you're just coasting, the car feels so smooth. So smooth. So it's really nice. Really nice. Over here, if we want to get into this turn, it keeps me, here's a turn, I'm turning the wheel, keeps me straight in my seat. Another turn up here, so smooth. It's just so smooth going over any kind of bump or anything. Big turn going 25 miles an hour around this turn, and then I'm turning. I'm out of my seat just a little bit, but it's still keeping me, but it's so smooth turning, so easy. You might move out of your seat just a little bit, you can feel it just a tiny bit. You might move out of your seat, it's not like you're in a racing seat or anything, but still, those bumps right there, pretty good soaking them up. Want to get back in coast. Quiet in here, going over some bumps. It soaks up the bumps pretty good and smooth. It might be my freaking mic hitting the pillar, but everything else is really smooth. I would say the only difference, since I've usually been on the height mode, is that when you turn, you move a little bit out of your seat. That's it. I can feel like a little bit out of my seat on turns, but that's about it. It's like little. So we got this turn coming down the hill. Here's another big windy turn. Just turn the wheel a little bit. So smooth. No, it's like not crazy. Even if I were to come down the hill really fast, it still keeps you, only moves you like a little bit out of your seat. Just a tiny bit. That's the only thing that I notice. Up this hill. in all, I would say the pressure still rides smooth. It hugs the bumps really good. The only thing I will say are the cons are that I noticed from a difference, which I'm gonna drive the I'm gonna set it to the hype mode once more before I give my honest opinion. But to me, the only cons is that I noticed is that you're moving your seat just a little bit in the corners. It moves you and you're out of your seat in the corners just a little bit. It still hugs the bumps pretty decent. Pretty decent. Alright, I'm gonna keep going and see if I notice anything else. So I'm gonna keep driving around here, around this little intersection. Smooth. If I decide, I want to air up and hit this turn right here, just air the car up, and I'm gonna hit this turn and go up this hill with no problem. Not because I'm too low, which is really nice, convenient. Gotta love that. Gotta love that. Gotta love that. All the way aired up on this hill. I know I might have scraped a little bit with how this hill is, but still nice. So the tank filled up pretty nice. Alright, I'm gonna go now, or not. And then go back to my ride height. Gotta like it. Definitely gotta like it. Pretty nice. So because I don't have the same exact presets that I have as the height sensors, I'm gonna make sure it's even and go to height, switch down to whatever I have it set, switch back to the pressure mode to see the drive, the same amount of drivability. So off we go. That bump, it sounded loud, but still ate the bump. The car is fine. Keep going. Run through the gears. Car is so smooth, like butter. I mean, you can feel little tiny. tiny bumps. If you're really picky, I'm trying to like find things to nitpick, and it's kind of hard to find little things to nitpick. I will say the only difference I notice is you move out of the seat just a little bit, and that's being really picky, really picky. That's being really picky. If you're in a turn, you might move out of the seat just a little bit. That's being like really picky. I mean, what more can you ask for? You might feel any little tiny bumps in a row. You're gonna feel smooth, but you after a while you might feel a little bounce. But I mean, it's not something you can't handle. It's like if you're really being picky, and you're like you want to feel like you're in a Mercedes or something. But overall, I would say it still feels really smooth and nice, and it handles the bump, especially for how low the car is right now. It feels nice. It really feels good. It still feels good. So, number one, you do move in your seat just a little bit, but you got to be really picky about it. It still feels smooth. So, those are only cons. You might feel a little bit of tiny bumps. It hugs the bumps really good. So now, I'm going to switch over to the height sensor. So, setup, operation, and then we're going to set it over to height. So, I just double click the ride height to make sure I'm at that ride height. And now let's go for the drive. And it feels smooth. Wow. I will say, under the height sensors, it hugs bumps way, way better. It's like a little, just a tiny little bump, and it hugs the bumps so smooth. It feels more planted, I would say. It feels even more planted. It feels so planted. It just feels so much firm.
All right. So I just changed the angle of the GoPro. Say under the 3P, You can feel a little bumps, but they're nothing crazy. They're like little tiny bumps on if you run into any little tiny bump. But you got to be really picky about it. And I will say that you move in your seat just a little bit, but it's nothing to be picky about. The car still feels smooth, precise, and you get on the gas. It still keeps you on the ground, and everything feels smooth. But with the height sensors, everything feels planted, and you don't move in your seat at all. You give a gas, your plan is on the ground, you're going full ahead, you're not jerky, nothing's jerky, shifting or anything, everything is just smooth, you hit the corner, straight line, everything just feels smooth, firm, and precise. I would say the height sensors, at the end of the day, I will go with the height sensors over it, the 3P any day. Just being able to jump on the back road and have that not moving your seat at all or anything and just be firm and flat to the ground, this is definitely, I would say, the way to go. The 3P is definitely the way to, not the 3P, the 3H is definitely the way to go. I would say it's definitely more firm, planted to the ground. I don't know what it is, but it just feels more firm, planted to the ground. You take a turn, you don't move at all in a turn. It's like you don't move all. Okay, you did turn. Okay, you're not going nowhere. With the pressure, it feels like you move a slightly bit more, but this, you don't move anywhere. You don't go anywhere. It's firm. It keeps you planted. It's really nice, I would say. So, if you guys like this video with the review with the Airlift Perfomance 3P versus the 3H, if you guys like this video, hit the thumbs up. If you want to see more content during this channel with the bag setup, etc., etc., and whatever more content I bring to the channel, subscribe to the channel. If you want to get notifications, hit the bell. And have a nice day. Thank you guys for watching.